Hello, musicians. So we're reaching the end of the school year, and I want to make sure that we feel really solid on some concepts that we have been working on all year through lots of different genres of music. So throughout this school year, you've learned about classical music, Baroque, Romantic. We've learned about jazz. We've learned about different genres of world music, Japanese classical music, Chinese, Korean, African music, Indian music. And we've also studied a lot of pop music for like different types of themes. So we've talked about songs for Mother's Day. We've talked about songs that make the world a better place. We've talked about Taylor Swift. And one thing that we've worked on in every single assignment is active listening. But before we close the school year, I want to make sure that you feel super, super solid in understanding what it means to be an active listener. I want you to never go through life again without the ability to listen to music and comprehend it. I have a quick story time before we get started with the lesson, but I was hanging out with a friend and we were listening to the song, If You Like Pina Coladas, and he was, saying that he really enjoyed the song. And I was like, "Do you know what this song is about?" And he was like, "No, not really." And it occurred to me, a lot of people just listen to music and they enjoy it, but they don't listen deeply into the music. And so I want to make sure that for the end of the year, you're listening deeply into the music. When you start listening to the lyrics of Pina Coladas, you realize that the characters in the song are not very good people. And they're both taking out personal ads because they want to cheat on their spouse, but they end up cheating with each other. Spoiler alert. But the song is really catchy and it feels like you're on a beach. And that's because we're singing about pina coladas. So I was talking about it with him and it occurred to me, you know, most people don't dig deep and listen deeply into the music, but you do. So for the remainder of the year, we're going to focus on that. I'm going to share my screen. For this assignment, you are going to need to have access to these Google Slides. And so this is what they look like. So these are the Google Slides. This is a Cornell Notes set of slides. And for all of your assignments this week, you have these 9 slides to fill out. I'm going to break up the lesson into a couple of different videos just to make it a little bit easier and do in more manageable chunks. But by the end of the week, you're going to turn in all of these slides for multiple grades. So I'll explain to you in each of the things, but you'll have a couple of slides due for one lesson, a couple of slides due for the next lesson, et cetera. As you're listening to the lecture, you can follow along and then you can use these slides to take notes. So when I tell you to pause the video, you can write directly into your slide. And then you can also do these fill in the blanks. If you are a person who would rather do things by hand, that is absolutely okay. You just need to make sure that you print this out. And if you print this out, you can go ahead and just do it on handwritten on paper. And that's fine with me too. But either way, you're going to turn in this multiple times to making sure that it's completely finished. And you're going to follow along with the lecture. So, our lecture is themed by our local record store here in Las Cruces. So shout out to one of my students who happens to be the family that owns this record store. You know who you are. And if you have not been to Iconic Records, you should definitely go check it out because it's an absolutely fantastic place to go. In your assignments, I'm also going to link a playlist. This is going to be a playlist that has every song mentioned in this lecture. We're going to go through a lot of them together, but I want to make sure that you have access to all of them so that you can listen to them. Okay, here we go. Active listening. So let's get busy. This is going to be fun. All right. So before we start, I want you to think about what makes a piece of music great. What makes music great to you? Is it the tempo? Is it the sound? Is it the way it makes you feel? Does it, what is it about music when you listen to it that makes you think it's a great song? Think about your favorite music. And then I want you to take time, pause the video, open up your slides, and type that in. And when you're finished with that, go ahead and unpause the video and then come back to the lecture. All right. So let's make sure that we're following along in these Cornell notes. And we're going to start off with what are the musical elements? So let's talk about this. We've been doing this all year. You should feel very comfortable with this. Musical elements are the building blocks of music, encompassing the fundamental components that make up a musical composition. The purpose of them is so that we can understand, to analyze, and appreciate music by identifying its various components. So I think before you took this class, you might have just been like, oh, I don't know, I like the beat. But now you have more tools, right? You have more vocabulary to explain why you like it. And you know more, especially after we did all our web quests, you know more of what instruments sound like. You know what brass instruments sound like, and you know what woodwinds sound like, and you know what keyboard instruments sound like. And now you have this language that you can use to identify and understand music. So we have broken that down for every single listening assignment this year into our key elements. Our key elements are melody, harmony, rhythm, texture, dynamics, and timbre. So these are the things that I ask you to write about. We really focused on this at the beginning of the school year, and I just want to circle back because this is the most important thing. If you don't learn anything else in music this year and you can't remember who Dizzy Gillespie is, that's okay. I want you to understand the key elements of music, and I want you to be able to listen to any music, whether it's something in the car or if you're in a waiting room or at a game, and be able to identify these elements of music and appreciate it on a deeper level. And these are the six elements that we're going to be discussing. So each of these are so important, and they contribute to everything. They contribute to the character, the mood, and the expression of a piece of music. This is going to shape the impact that it has on you emotionally, and it's going to give the artist some interpretation. Think about a Taylor Swift song. Some of her songs are upbeat, but they're sad. Her new album that just came out has a great line. I cry a lot, but I am so productive. That album is a great demonstration of something that's upbeat but sad. Sometimes it matches, sometimes it mismatches. And you need to know these elements so that you can identify what makes it special. Does it match? Does it not match? Okay, we're gonna start with melody. And don't forget, you have your Cornell notes here to take notes on all of these. So make sure you're following along, pausing the video as you need to. You can feel free to slow it down or speed it up so that you can get all of these notes filled out. Melody is a sequence of musical notes. That's it. It's just a sequence of musical notes. It's a pattern of notes. What makes a melody is that it's memorable and the main theme or tune is something that sticks in your brain. All right. So I'm sure you can think of melodies of songs that are really popular, and those are the ones that stick in your brain. These are going to be successions of pitches with rhythmic patterns. So it can't just be notes. There has to be a rhythmic pattern as well so that you can hear it and recognize it as the melody. And that's all that it is. It's just the way it goes. So let's talk about some songs with some really recognizable melodies. First of all, we have Oops, I Did It Again by Britney Spears. And I just wanted to remind you that I put a playlist together of all of these songs for you so that you can go through and listen. And you are going to be choosing some of your own songs from this playlist to listen to and write about eventually. Oops, I Did It Again is good. The Phantom of the Opera, for those of you who are musical theater fans, Take On Me is good. Yesterday by Paul McCartney is one of the most memorable melodies there is. And Barbie Girl. Let's listen to a little bit of Barbie Girl because I know that you know this song.
I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Life in plastic, it's fantastic.
So you have probably heard that before, especially since the Barbie movie came out this summer. And you know, or like last summer, because we're almost into summer again, you know what a popular song this is. But if you just heard somebody even humming, da 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 da, you would know that it was Barbie Girl because you would recognize that melody. And that is what melody is. It's a memorable group of pitches and rhythms. All right. Harmony. Let's talk about harmony next. So, if you recall, harmony is the simultaneous sounding of two or more pitches in music simultaneously. That means that two pitches that are different are sounding at the same time. These combinations of different musical notes produce chords or chord progressions. All right. So these are going to help us to know what chords are being played, but it's going to add depth and color and richness to the music, and it's going to create tension in the music or resolution to the music. So there's a lot of songs with really great harmony, and I put lots of examples in there. A great example is In My Room by the Beach Boys. If you have never heard that one, it's really fun and it's in your playlist, so you can listen to it. Bohemian Rhapsody is a great one, and you probably have heard Bohemian Rhapsody a million zillion times, and you can hear that, like, that part where it's like, I see a little silhouette of a man, and then all those voices come in on the Scaramouche, and that is really big for that. If you've ever heard the Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy of Company B, that is so rich in harmony that there's not really one that carries the melody. They're all the melody. The Flower Duet is one that you've probably heard in a Ghirardelli chocolate commercial. It's very, very beautiful. When you listen to it, you will know what it is. Let's listen to Extreme, More Than Words by Extreme, mostly because you probably haven't heard of the band Extreme. And if you have, good for you. But I want to make sure that you hear about them. So we're going to listen to Extreme. You're going to hear two men singing together at the same time. They're singing different pitches, and that is what makes the harmony.
How easy it would be to show me how you feel. More than words is all you have to do to make it real. Then you wouldn't have to say that you love me.
So you can hear those two men singing at different times, and it just really sound really strong together. Let me show you a little bit of the Flower Duet. So I'm sure, like I said, you've heard that in a Ghirardelli chocolate commercial. So that is an example of a beautiful harmony. Both of the women had melodies, but they were singing them at the same time and they were different. Together, they make harmony. Rhythm. Okay, so I know that rhythm is something that you all understand. You understand rhythm and beat, and we've talked about this a lot, but rhythm is a pattern of sound and silences. So you have this organization of beats or pulses in time. This is going to give music its sense of movement and groove, and it's created just by an arrangement of notes and accents and durations. So here is an example of one. I can't clap in a Zoom meeting and it show the sound because it blocks out ambient noise. So I'm going to have to do it with my mouth, but we're going to just see if you can recognize this one. So it's like boom, boom, ch, boom, boom, ch, boom, boom, ch, boom, boom, ch. What song did you think of immediately when I was doing that? Hopefully it was We Will Rock You. Would have clapped it, but doesn't work in a Zoom. So I'm not gonna clap in the Zoom and you're not gonna be able to hear it. So We Will Rock You is a great example. That's probably one of the most common examples. You may have also heard bum 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 bum. And you can hear that knocked. Again, I can't knock in a Zoom, but that dun 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 dun. And immediately you want to go bum bum. And that is a very recognizable rhythm. Okay. And I put a recording of that in there too. We've got Billie Jean. You hear the beginning of Billie Jean and you immediately know. So let's play a couple of examples for you on this. You should recognize this. It should feel very familiar. So this was a great example for melody too, because of the ding, 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 ding is very popular. But that percussive rhythm at the beginning, that is an example of a memorable melody, rhythm. Here's another example of a memorable rhythm in classical music. So you hear this rhythm and it's going bum 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 bum. This is memorable because it is in 5/4 time, not in 4/4 time, which is an unusual meter. So normally songs go bum 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 bum. They're in 4/4 time. This one is bum 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 4 and 5, 1 and a 2. 3, 4, and 5. And that five feels a little bit uncomfortable. And it's meant to feel uncomfortable because we're not supposed to feel comfortable when we're talking about the planets. So, this is The Planets by Holst. He has a song for every planet except for Pluto, because Pluto wasn't a planet when this piece of music came out. And then it was a planet, and then they took it away, and then it became a planet again. That's a conversation for your science teacher. But musically, he has the planets in our solar system. And he has a song for what he believes those should sound like. Very, very cool, cool stuff. So, we have learned today about melody, harmony, and rhythm. We are going to pause the video here. I'm going to pick back up right where we left off for the next video, but you can take some time to go through and fill out your melody, harmony, and rhythm. So for your first assignment, you're just going to have to fill out the first slide, melody, melody, harmony, up to rhythm. And then in your next assignment, you'll fill out the rest of the slides. So we'll stop this video here and I will pick up with the next one. I hope that you had have had a good time listening, and I hope that you go spend some time with this playlist and listen to more of these songs all the way through, because they are really cool. So I will see you in the next video.